and then change our behavior accordingly. So far, we have considered two main routes of transmission. One is infection by coming into contact with something that has the virus on it. The other is infection through droplets emitted in sneezes and coughs. But some experts say there is possibly a third infection route.
Experts are now looking at this new infection mechanism as the key to preventing the further spread of the virus.
ただの会話の中で感染が広がっているとか、ある程度の距離があってもそれが広がっているような、そういった事例を見ると、通常の飛沫感染だけでは説明できない。非常に小さな粒子ということで、マイクロメーターの粒子、マイクロ飛沫感染とも呼べるような、そういった状況が起きたんじゃないかなというふうに考えられます。So
how does this take place? NHK is conducting an experiment with a group of researchers. The team will track particles in the air using laser beams and a high-sensitivity camera. This technology allows us to detect droplets as small as 0.1 micrometers wide. The experiment starts. First, sneezing. We can see a large droplet, about 1 millimeter in diameter. It quickly falls. But let's look through the high sensitivity camera. We can see small particles that seem to glitter floating through the air. These particles are all smaller than 10 micrometers, or 1/100th of a millimeter in diameter. Let's take a look from a different angle. They're small and light. You can see them drifting through the air. These are micro droplets. We're learning that sneezing isn't the only source of these droplets.
Banana boat とか乗ったら楽しいですよ。いや、絶対楽しい。めちゃくちゃ楽しい。僕、
We ran the same experiment on a close-range conversation. People generate a lot of micro-droplets when they talk loudly. The droplets between these two stay where they are. They don't drift away. It's not yet known what volume of micro-droplets leads to infection. But Tateda says we can't rule out the possibility that micro-droplets have spread the virus to some extent.
その micro飛沫、小さな粒子の中にもたくさんのですね、生きたウイルスがいて、 大きな声での会話、あるいは激しい息遣い、そういった中でですね、このマイクロ飛沫ができて、それが近くの人、その人が吸い込むことによって感染が広がる、そういったリスクが見えてきたものと思います。The
risk of infection through micro droplets becomes even greater in a closed space with poor ventilation. This lab is simulating the movement of micro-droplets in an airtight room. About 10 people in an enclosed space the size of a classroom. A person coughs once and spreads about 100,000 droplets. Large droplets are shown in blue and green. Most of these fall to the ground within 1 minute. But the micro droplets, shown in red, continue to drift. This simulation uses only micro droplets. 5 minutes later, 10 minutes later, twenty minutes later, the micro droplets are still floating in place.
空気が淀んでいると、つまり空気の流れがないということで、マイクロ飛沫そのものは、落ちたり、違う場所に動くことはできませんので、長時間その場所にとどまるということになります。
But there is a way to prevent this stagnation of micro droplets. Opening windows and increasing air circulation is believed to be effective.When you open a window, micro droplets are quickly swept away. They're very small and light, so any airflow will get rid of them.
できればですね、2箇所開けて風の流れを作ってあげるということが大事。それが、1時間に1回でもいいから、そういうようなことをやることによって、感染のリスクというのはかなり下げることができるようになるんじゃないかなというふうに思います。
We're now joined by Mitsuo Kaku, a professor at Tohoku Medical and Pharmaceutical University. He specializes in the prevention and treatment of infectious diseases.We just learned how micro droplets move, but we don't know if this brings a high risk of infection for the new coronavirus. Professor Oshitani, you've been watching the actual spread of the virus. Do you think micro droplets are spreading infection?
I don't think airborne infection has occurred. If it had, there would already have been a large-scale outbreak here in Japan.We believe most infections have been through large droplets or through contacts. But it is possible that micro droplets can cause short distance transmission in exceptional cases. And this can lead to a cluster. People who have mild symptoms still carry the virus. They might not sneeze or cough or even have a fever.But they still release the virus when they talk loudly or breathe heavily. And by doing so, they release large amounts of the virus, and it's highly likely that this is creating clusters.
Professor Kaku, what do you think we should be most careful about when considering micro droplet infection?
You have to avoid the three situations Professor Oshitani pointed out earlier.
And what are those?
Closed spaces, areas where many people gather, and close-range conversations. You have to avoid all three. And it's necessary to ventilate, particularly in medical facilities, where there could be a lot of micro droplets.One place that's a really big concern is the waiting room. Here, lots of people are concentrated for long periods of time. People talk while they wait, and this leads to micro droplets in the air. And if ventilation is poor, that could mean infection. So the air needs to be constantly flowing, and we need to make sure people don't come all at the same time.
Professor Oshitani,Those three situations you listed, do you think they're a big part of the current spread of the virus?
We saw from the beginning that the risk of infection was very high in these three situations. They have to be avoided as much as possible. This is very important in our fight against COVID-19. We've been emphasizing this from the start.But even now, these situations haven't been reduced. You see them all the time, even in large venues with lots of people. Japan has been really lucky so far in that we haven't had any large-scale clusters. But you can't just expect that to continue. If we don't do anything, then there will be a large-scale cluster soon, And when that happens, our medical system will not be able to handle it. People need to remember this before they plan events or activities and think about how their behavior can prevent a large-scale outbreak here in Japan.
This is all important information, but many people are worried about how long the situation will last. Let's take a look at the situation in the Chinese